So in today's game, we're gonna have Joe playing the new Tyranid Codex that just came out with some Gene Stealer cult allies, and Greg will be playing Craftworld with Yunari allies. Since it's Tyranids, we're gonna do the No Mercy Eternal War mission. So that's just kill points and slay the Warlord first blood Linebreaker. But let's just go right into the armies, and Joe, why don't you tell us about yours?
Unfortunately, didn't have a ton of time to try and get a Tyranid list up, so I was trying to go for the more expensive units that I could quickly get done. So I haven't gotten any Termagants or Hormagants up. The cheapest people in my army are just my Gene Stealers, but I had some Gene Stealer cult done already, so fleshed out the points with them. So making up my army, I've got two battalion detachments. The Tyranid Battalion is led by the Swarm Lord, who will be my army's warlord. I gave him the Adaptive Biology warlord trait. So when he takes damage, once he's taken damage, he reduces future damage by one to a minimum of one.
Is that permanent for the rest of the game?
Yeah.
And what high fleet are you running?
I'm running as the Jormungandr. So everyone counts as being in cover unless they charge or they advance, and then they regain at the beginning of my next movement phase. Swarm Lord knows the Horror and Catalyst psychic powers, and I gave him so he's the army's warlord, and then I have as my second HQ a Neurothrope. He's got the army's relic, which is the Norn Crown for the 30-inch synapse, because none of the other ones could be taken. His psychic powers, he knows Psychic Scream. I have a 4-man unit of Zoanthropes who know the Catalyst psychic power. I have a unit of 3 Hive Guard with Impaler Cannons. 2 3-man units of Tyranid Warriors. In each squad, 2 of them have Death Spitters. One of the squads has a Venom Cannon and the other has a Bog Strangler. I have a 8-man unit of Gene Stealers with Rending Claws. No other upgrades. For my Gene Stealer cult battalion, I have a Magus who knows the Mass Hypnosis psychic power, a Primus, and I have 2 squads of Neophyte Hybrids. One of them is geared out for close combat. They have 2 Flamers, a Cult Icon, and a Power Pick. The other one is just a squad of 10 with auto guns, and the close combat squad are armed with shotguns. For my third troop, I have a unit of 5 Acolyte Hybrids with 2 Rock Saws, and then I have a unit of 6 Hybrid Metamorphs with 4 Hand Flamers, a Cult Icon, 2 Metamorph Claws, 2 Metamorph Talons, and 2 Metamorph Whips to flesh out my army. And my Gene Stealer cult is 6 of my 13 units, so I can bring all of them in via their cult ambush special rule to give them a bit more mobility.
And then with 2 battalions, you have 9 command points?
Yeah.
So let's take a look at Greg's army now.
Okay, so since Joe's running Gene Stealer cult with Tyranids, we figured we would do the same type of thing with the Craftworld Eldar and the Yunari. So for my main detachment, I have a battalion with their Altiac Craftworld. I've got a Farseer. He's got Doom and Guide. For his relic, I gave him the Phoenix Gem, just because it's cool. 3 squads of Rangers. And Elec up top for the other HQ, giving me 3 command points. Then I have 2 detachments of Yunari. First off, we'll go through the Vanguard. 3 squads of Howling Banshees with Exarchs with mirror swords in each, and the Avatar of Death. And then over here on the other side, we also have a Vanguard detachment. We've got the Solitaire and 2 Death Jesters with a Troopmaster with a Fusion Pistol and a Harlequin's Caress and a Bike Squad with Zephyrblaze on it. think that's it. Mine was much quicker than Joe's. Yeah.
Well, so total, you have
14 units, so that will matter for deployment. And then I have 8 command points.
Okay, so we finished up deployment on both sides. As the Eldar player, I'm going to roll to seize, which will depend on where I put my rangers at. So here's the roll off. I do not seize, and I will not command point it.
So all of the Eldar forces have been deployed. You have rangers here, but that's 2 squads right there?
2 squads, one on the top, second on the bottom, third squad's over here with Elik right behind them.
But there's no Gene Steel Occult on the table yet, right?
Correct. All of the Gene Steel Occult are waiting in ambush to come in at the end of one of my movement phases.
And Greg did not see, so it's going to be Tyranid's turn one, right?
Yep. The Gene Steel Occult have arrived in force from their ambush. The only good ambush roll I got was the hybrid metamorphs. I attached the Primus to them, and they got the one that they came in 9 inches, more than 9 inches away and got to move or shoot. I chose to have them move, and I used one of my command points to reroll the move dice so that they could move forward 6. The Magus came in with one of the squads of neophytes, just back here to cast psychic powers out. The squad of acolyte hybrids and the neophyte hybrids just came in the center of the board. They had to be more than 12 inches away from the enemy, and I just wanted them to hang back to countercharge when the Howling Banshees reached the line. The Gene Stealers formed a bubble around the Swarm Lord so that he won't receive a charge from the Howling Banshees. He moved up so that he'd be in range of the Rangers for his psychic powers. Neither the Neurothrope, I can't really cast any psychic powers because I don't want to kill any of the Rangers and not get my charge off. And the squad of Zoanthropes is outside of range of any of their psychic powers. And the squad of 3 Hive Guard stayed still so they wouldn't suffer any penalty. So I'm going to start my psychic phase with Mass Hypnosis from the Magus onto the squad of Rangers. It is warp charge value 7. Goes off with an 8.
2. What does that do?
Until it's on my next psychic phase, the target cannot fire Overwatch, fights last, and must subtract 1 from its hit rolls.
I'll try to deny it. You got an 8?
Yep.
I got a 9.
Okay. The Swarm Lord will try and cast Smite onto the top unit of Rangers in that ruin.
Are they the closest one? Or is the mid-level one?
They have the mid-level one to be closest. So onto the mid-level guys. Goes off with a 6.
Okay, I have nothing to stop it.
So D3. 1. And then he is going to attempt to cast the horror onto the top unit of Rangers.
Okay.
Warp charge value of 6. Goes off with an 11. So that will be minus 1 to their 2 hit rolls and leadership.
Okay. On the top squad.
Yeah. Going into the shooting, I will have the 3 Hive Guard will shoot their impaler cannons into this squad of Howling Banshees. They can target units that are outside of line of sight, range 36.
I was about to say.
So, hitting on 3s. All hit. And strength 8. So, wounding on 2s. 5 wounds minus 2 AP.
Okay.
So what's profound?
They have a 4 plus, so they'll have a 6. How many saves was it?
5.
5?
Strength 8 minus 2 AP, D3 damage.
So looking for sixes?
It's expensive, but...
None. Five that.
Okay. Next, I will have this unit of neophytes. We'll fire their autoguns into the three Harlequin bikes. Ten shots, hitting on fives. Four hits, and wounding on fives. Twos.
Dos wundos. Under the bikes.
Yep.
Is this usually the, is this like the trademark Harlequin bike formation?
One wound. That's the, right.
Sweet.
No. So it will just be, should have fired him first, the Venom Cannon from this unit of warriors will fire into that the same Harlequin bike squad.
Okay.
So hit with his Venom Cannon, he gets D3 shots. Three. Hitting on fives. Two hits. It is strength 8.
1.
Okay. This one DP game?
Yeah.
We're up. I'll command point that. So I go from 8 to 7 command points. And I pass my save.
Okay. The unit of warriors over here is going to fire into the bottom squad of rangers with their death spitters and the Bob Strangler. So, Bob Strangler. Actually, Bob Strangler will go into the unit of Howling Banshees directly ahead of it.
Okay.
Yeah. So I do the 6 death spitter shots into the bottom unit of rangers. What's the minus anthem?
Minus 2.
They the crap world?
Yes.
Yeah. So minus 2.
Hitting on 6s. Nothing.
And I can't believe it.
D6 shots onto the unit of Howling Banshees. 3. Hitting on 4s. And wounding on 3. Strength 5. 2 wounds minus 1 HP.
Okay. Looking for 5s. Good.
That will be all of my shooting, so I'm just going to go into assaults. The Primus and this squad are both going to attempt to assault into the Rangers.
Okay.
I assume the squad's going first?
Yeah, squad going first.
So 5 overwatches. Nothing.
Roll squad. 9 inches.
Alright.
And on the Primus. 9 inches and block. One of them kitted out differently. What's the Rangers armor save?
Guessing 5.
Let me check here real quick. Rangers. They have a save of 5 plus.
Yeah, they'll just all attack with their rending claws. So 6.
Right. Bless you. 12.
So here's the attacks from the hybrid metamorph. Don't need to do the metamorph leader. They have the icon, so they're hitting on 2 plus, rerolling 1s for the primus. Then they are strength 4, so wounding on 3s. So 3, 5, 7 so far, and then the squad leader, 4 hits, 0-1, wounding on 3s. So 9 wounds at minus 1 AP and then 1 minus 4.
Okay, so the minus 4 I can't do anything about, and then I have 9 6 up saves.
Thank you, mate. Thanks.
They're dead.
So that's first blood for the Tyranids.
That's right. And then
that's your main guy?
Did you charge him too?
No.
Okay. Yeah, that's it. So, I will go ahead and place the Avatar of Death as close as possible without being an inch with it to you. So I believe that it's probably either up one level or down one level. I think they're both equal distance.
They're directly above.
It'd be like right here would be...
I'm being directly above as a legal placement.
Right here?
Yeah. So I think it would either be there or equal spot below them.
Gotcha.
I think it'd be equal distance. You'd have the choice. Or Joe has the one guy there.
Yeah, so I think here is the best.
So that's everything from the Tyranids.
So I just have a leadership test on the Banshee. LD8, I lost 5. I got a 2, so I'm good. All right. Okay, so at the beginning of the game, I forgot to say the Avatar of Death has Gaze of Yanid and Word of the Phoenix for their psychic powers. In the movement phase, I used the stratagem Mattress Agility to add 6 inches instead of a d6 inches to the Howling Banshee's advance roll.
Who'd you use it?
Single Howling Banshee. So, that I am now down to 6 command points, and I'm going to start off with my psychic power phase here. So first things first, I'm going to go ahead and cast a guide onto Illic up top there. I rolled a 6. Forgot to grab my second card. Warp charge value of 7. So I will use my runes and re-roll that 1. A 3. So guide goes off. Are you close enough and do you wish to try to deny it?
I will not try and deny.
Okay.
Then I will also cast Doom onto the squad you have there closest to me. I got a 6. Is it warp charge 7?
Yes.
Okay. Then, I will use one more command point, moving me down to 5, and use Unparalleled Mastery, which allows me to use an additional psychic power from my Farseer after I have manifested my maximum. So I will do Smite onto that unit. And it goes off with a 7.
I will try and deny it from my Neurothrope.
Okay, so it does not go off. And then onto the Avatar of Death.
It'll be -1 to a psychic test from the Shadow of the Wall.
Gotcha. It will cast Gaze of Yanid onto this guy here. So it's an 8, so I'll need a 9. Does not go off. And then I will also attempt to cast Word of the Phoenix, which is warp charge 6, which means I'll need a 7. It goes off with an 8.
Yeah,
which gives me an extra soul, lets me cast the soul burst action onto it.
So I'm about to try and deny.
Does not. I shall throw it onto the Harlequin bikes for another shooting phase. So they will use shooting phase to target the squad here. Shuriken cannons hitting on 3s. T6, they're wounding on 2s. One at -3, and then 5 regulars.
So 5 up saved. 5 in total.
Okay. Now onto the shooting phase. We'll go ahead and start out with that bike squad again. And I will fire onto the squad in the building. 3's the hit. And are they also T3?
Yep.
2's the wound. 1 at -3, and then 4 regular saves, and you're in cover.
Tim, you said 4 regular?
Yep.
So 4 forearms, 1 bonus.
Okay.
Make it a little harder for the Howling Banshee.
Alright. Illic Nightspear is going to, he will shoot onto the, what's this called, Neurothrope?
Neurothrope.
He'll shoot onto the Neurothrope. 2 plus, and he's guided. He hits on a 5. And, Strength 4.
Toughness 4.
Okay, well, it wounds on 2 plus. Never mind.
Oh,
I haven't used it in the shooting phase, so...
How much damage does it do?
It does 3, so it won't kill him, I'm guessing.
He's got 3 up and won 5 wounds. Does it cause any kind of what
wounds? On a 6. Flex it more. So, yeah, it's probably not. Alright, on to more shooting. The squad up top is going to shoot onto these hive guard here. So I've got 5 of them. They're -1 to hit, correct?
Yeah.
So 4 ups. And then, what's the deal with the sniper weapons? I think
it's strength 4 and 6 is a mortal wounds.
Toughness 5.
Toughness 5, so nothing. And then, 2 guys on the middle can shoot the hive guard, so they will fire.
Who are the other 2 going to shoot?
The other 2, I do not believe, have line of sight to anyone.
Somewhere.
I don't think so, because of the way the window is set up. I looked already.
Yeah.
I don't think they can. I could be wrong.
Hey, they could shoot over into the guys in the building.
Oh, alright. Well, then that works. We'll do into the building first.
Guys in the building being these guys.
Yeah.
Yep. 2 hits. 2 wounds.
Any minus?
Nope.
4.
Then the other 2 under the hive guard. 1 hit. Nothing. The death jesters are in range. Because I don't think they can see into the building. They are just out, but
all through the door.
Yeah. And the other one, yeah. So, the pink one shall fire first at the Gene Stealers.
The Gene Stealers really on 25 mil?
Fine, that's what. The boxes I bought.
And are they D4?
Yep.
1 regular and 1 at -3.
So, 2 5 ups.
And depending on what you take out, blue guy has yet to fire. So, it might be out of range. Go through the door to make sure.
Yeah, you got her.
Okay.
Oh, assuming you can see that guy, I guess. This dude over here. You're not in range of him. Can you see this dude here? She's super in range of him.
No. You're not.
No.
That one guy is out of range, huh?
Can you see this guy over here?
No way with the angle. Well, you have to look from the other guy's point of view, probably, so. Yeah, let me go the full 24. I was way out of range, you said?
I mean, like, way it was like 2. Alright. You're like half an inch out.
Ugh! Ah! And he's out of the.
Yeah, I mean, it's like
so close.
Yeah.
All right. For death jester, you just didn't have the distance. This foot belt didn't help him enough. Troop master will shoot his fusion
into the
the vile beast upon the ruin. He hits. He wounds. No!
Killed him.
Alright. I believe that's all the shooting. You guys see anything else?
Hey, you don't have that much shooting.
Yeah. I know.
Does the boss here have a pistol? Or maybe grenades?
Shuriken pistol. Yes, 2 plus, hits, strength 4, wounds,
4,
okay, good. Alright, now we see if the Banshee can make it. Did you give me a measurement on it,
Do they have anything that they ignore?
I mean, you go for the guy on the grass.
Looks like 6, or... It's either 6 or 5.
Okay, and he gets a +3, so
she gets plus
she gets
three.
A +3. I'm sorry.
Don't misgender her.
So she makes it. Now the troop master will go in.
Is he attacking the HQ dude or
both? There's a separate guy. There,
yeah, right? You could assault both. You want.
But then the one will get to Overwatch.
Yeah.
What does the HQ have to Overwatch with?
Has a needle pistol. Needle.
Just like Maria.
That's right. Man.
It always wounds on a 2 plus. That's it.
Okay. But you have to hit me on the 6. So he'll go in on, yeah, both. Oh my god. Nope. 4.
Yeah, that's what they need, right?
Yeah. And then, let's see. How far away are these bikes from the squad there?
Maybe. 7 possibly.
Do you have a devastating weaponry to overwatch me with?
They are equipped with las guns.
Alright. Well, then I will assault them with the bikes.
Sixteen shots.
You would sleep.
3 fives.
1. Good. So here we go for the charge. A 10. So go ahead and move those guys in. And the solitaire is going to try to assault into the ruins combat. I'll just roll it up and see if he can make it. He got snake eyes, so he won't be. The farseer is going to try to assault into that combat also. He got a 9, so he will make it. And just I guess to make sure, the Avatar of Death will go in.
Wait,
I don't think she's close enough to hit anybody else.
Well, she's close enough to get a soul burst from it, though, right? Like she's within 7.
So then she could make a move. And then a charge, right? No?
No, she can charge.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, she could do a charge. She could move and charge.
Yeah.
I don't know. Did she get a fight? I think she gets a fight.
Yeah.
If Greg kills him, then the Avatar gets his soul burst, and she gets charged. I think she would get to fight in this situation.
How far away is she from this Nero throw?
I think over 12.
Yeah, it's more than 12.
Wait, is it less than 13? Oh, no, you have to be within 12 to declare.
Only the Howling Banshees get that expertise. So, yeah, she might as well just go into the ground. She got a 5.
Yeah.
All right, and then that's it. So, I guess first off, we do, how good is the character?
Not good.
Okay, well then I'll do the squad of guys over here. Harlequin bikes. Strength 4. 3 attacks each. Hitting on 3 pluses. Wounding on 3s. They do 2 damage. Mm. Alright. 3 at negative 2.
You did.
Okay. And would you like to interrupt with anyone?
What's the same? What's your like profile on your Zephasia here?
Zephasia? Has 5 wounds, 6 up save, 4 plus invulnerable save, and he's T3.
They're not worth it. Primus won't kill him.
Gotcha. Alright. Well, then I shall attack with my Farseer first onto him. He gets 2 attacks. 2 ups to hit. 1 hit. Witchblade.
Wounds on 2 plus.
Wounds on 2 plus. Wounds. No AP.
And he was attacking the character?
Yep.
So, 5 up. Good.
Good. Okay. Now the Howling Banshee with its Mirror Blades. Mirror Swords, I'm sorry. 3 attacks. 3 ups. I believe rerolls. Rerolls fail hits. 2 hits. Strength 3, so 4s. 1 at negative 2.
He's dead.
Okay. And the troop master will do. I think he has 5 attacks. Yes. He'll do. How many wounds does your HQ have? 5? Okay. Well, then he'll so he'll do 4 attacks on him and 1 attack on the other. So 2 pluses. 4 hits. Strength 5. 3s. Reroll to wound. 4 at negative 2.
On
the Primus.
So he's at 1 wound.
Okay, and then the other one. 1 hits. Wounds, negative 2.
kill point.
All right. And then the Avatar went against the troop and not the HQ, so you're good to go.
The Primus will swing.
Oh wait, I killed so I can make a soul burst, correct?
That's true.
So
you could have the Troop Master fight again.
The Troop Master could fight again, or the Avatar could recharge. I will have the Troop Master refight again.
Another soul burst.
Another soul burst.
Yeah, I mean, you could move her now.
Yes. The Avatar. We'll move up behind the bikes.
How far did you move?
7.
Can you measure, Jim? I don't have
a hand. And then that's it. Oh, yeah, you got your attack for that.
So it's going up behind the bikes?
Yep. She just doesn't want to be the closest thing to the.
So six attacks back. Getting fours.
Oh, forgot about my soul burst. This would have been terrible.
It's true.
That's like four. The thing that I get.
One moon.
Four up. And feel no pain because of Yunari. To 5, 9, and 6. So takes another one. So the back bike has one wound left.
And then I will use 2 command points so they auto pass their morale.
Alright. And that is the end of turn 1.
With all the Tyranid units on the board, no one new to arrive. I fell back from combat with the squad of neophytes so I can fire at the bikes. Moved the Magus and the Neurothrope have both moved back so they are outside of denial range of the Farseer, so it's just denial from him. The unit of Gene Stealers, they lost 2 in their leadership 9 so they didn't have to take a leadership test. They've moved out towards the Howling Banshees. The Swarmlords come out from behind the ruin to stop moving against the Rangers. The 2 units of warriors move slightly just to reposition, and the Hive God continued to remain still. Starting my psychic phase, I'm going to have the Zoanthrope squad is going to attempt to cast Catalyst onto the Gene Stealers. That is warp charge value 6.
Good job, Chip.
Goes off with 8.
So that's feel no pain?
Yeah.
And who casts it? The Swarmlord?
The Zoanthropes.
So and let me see if I'm within 24 with the Avatar.
Okay. Yeah, you're within 24.
Okay. I'll try to deny. I do with an 11.
Okay, whoa. The Magus over here is going to use Smite onto the Harlequin bikes.
Okay.
Looking for a 5+. I get a 5.
Let me see if the Farseer is within range.
He's out of range of him.
Okay. You did that on purpose, sure.
Did.
Alright. So, how much damage?
2.
2? So one dies and the wound spells over. Or I get my feel no pain from the Avatar.
Yep.
So 2 6 pluses. Nothing. So what I said happened. So he's got 2 wounds left.
The Neurothrope will use Psychic Scream onto the bikes.
Is that like a re-tip screen?
Probably. So it's warp charge value 5. Goes off on 7.
Okay, and did he also get out of range of the Farseer?
Yeah.
Okay.
So D3.
On the bikes?
Yep.
6 up, feel no pain. Nope, goes through. Takes another wound, he's got one left.
He will then. I can't only run the first.
Let me double check that.
He can manifest too. So he's then going to attempt to cast Smite onto the bikes again.
Okay.
I will reroll the 1 because of his warp siphon. Goes off with an 8.
I can't stab it.
So that'll be 3. 3.
3, feel no pains. Nope, they all go through. So he dies and the other one has 1 wound left.
My psychic face.
Loop. Loop, loop.
At least that stopped Catalyst.
The Zoanthropes will cast Smite onto the bikes. Well, he could move or assault. If he assaults, he'll easily kill them. Do you do the assault immediately, or does he just...
He just charges, and then you fight in the fight phase. But he could also cast the Psychic Power.
Yeah, he could move. He could shoot.
He could move. He doesn't have anything to shoot with.
I think it's worth casting Smite to try and kill him, or...
I mean, do you care about that squad?
Not really. So yeah, I'll try and cast Smite from the Zoanthropes onto him. Goes off with an 8. Does 2.
Double sixes! Aw, so close. I could reroll that with my hand. But I won't. So, Soul Burst action time. He is... What else is in charge? So, you have some pretty nasty shooting. I will try to charge him.
So, 10 shots. Two hits. And then 6 is enough.
How far away am I?
Need a 7.
Okay. 9. He's in.
She's
in.
Alright, that's... the Swarm Lord will attempt to cast...
I'm going to teleport him. To the bike.
He will attempt to cast the horror on this front unit of Howling Banshees. Warp charge value 6. Goes off with 11. So that's minus 1 to hits and leadership.
Okay. On the front squad of Howling Banshees.
Yeah. And then he will try and cast Smite onto the bottom level Rangers.
Okay.
5. Take out my jeans too, I'm gonna be pretty upset.
Yeah, it's wild. I think we need to counterweight that.
Put some objective tokens. The Hive Guard will fire. Do you think I fire into the front squad of Howling Banshees?
No, you just debuffed them and they're guaranteed charge.
We'll just be. Well. And if he soul bursts them, then he counts as charging, so he'd get to swing first.
I just don't shoot him enough to kill him.
I mean, six shots. So
I mean, split. Eight, so. What's the range? Can you hit the one over here?
It's range 36.
Although this would give him a soul burst. But does that really matter?
I don't think that there is. The outside of 12, so. So one of the Hive God will fire into the Lone Howling Banshee, the other two will fire into the back squad.
Okay.
So one on the solo Howling Banshee, hitting on threes, both hit. Wounding on twos, two wounds, minus two AP.
You're recovering.
So five ups, dead.
Then, what are you going to do with your... Oh, wait. You resolve this entire attack first.
And then the four shots into the back squad. Three hits. Moving on...
Twos.
Yeah, moving on twos. Two.
Six pluses. Two die.
So, which two are you taking out? Back ones? Forward ones?
Yeah, take out the back too.
And then...
So, Howling Banshee died, so the Troop Master can, Soul Burst 7 inches. The Solitaire was out of 7, correct?
I think so. She was right here.
Yeah.
Okay. So... Troop Master can move.
Over here will fire into the top unit of Rangers.
Okay.
So, six Death Spitter shots, hitting on sixes. Two hits. Wounding on threes. One wound. Minus one AP.
Okay. So... That ignores the cover.
What does it?
Minus one AP. I got a one, so one dies.
Oh, I mean, you get plus two cover because you're.
That's right. So it's I got a one, so one dies. Who's the top squad?
Yeah. Okay. And then the Bob Strangler. D6 shots. Six. Hitting on sixes. Two hits. One.
Any negative?
I think it's minus one.
Good.
So, let me see. That window's curved too much for this warrior to see anything. There's no other squads. So, is it worth using that one stratagem for two command points to get for them to shoot again?
I mean, they're pretty good.
I would say so.
Well, I mean, who are you going to shoot? Well, the squad of Banshees, Greg's Banshees can assault you.
I think I fire two of them at that one. But then where would the other two shots be put into best? Because, like, everything over here is just characters.
Yeah.
So it'd just be the Rangers, and they'd just be hitting on
six
fives. They
don't forget,
plus.
The Harlequin characters over there are Yanari, so they'll be able to Solbrist also. If you kill Banshee. If I so desired, if they weren't. Because I think the Death Jesters are within range.
Yeah, that one.
Is there anything else I can do?
So that's the only problem with that.
I mean, you could just put them in the rangers. It's not the most useful thing.
Well, like, is that worth 2 command points?
You're going to kill the one squad of rangers, presumably.
Think.
You can put them into both squads. You're going to weaken them so bad that they won't be effective. If you had one on the back squad and 2 on the front squad, what? I mean...
It says, in addition, units targeted by attack by this weapon do not gain the bonus for being in cover. Would that just be the normal +1, or would that affect, like, Greg's +2?
I think it would get rid of the +2. Because he gets +2 instead of +1 being covered.
All right, I guess I'll use that. I'm going to use Single-Minded Annihilation on the Hive Guard for 2 command points, and they can immediately shoot again.
Well, this is at the end of your shooting phase.
Yeah,
is
that's how... Yeah, everything's out of ranger, moved in.
Or an assault.
So they will fire all their shots. Top squad.
I think you're gonna shoot some of them. I mean, I think shooting the 2 in that squad, and then assuming you don't kill, and then just hitting the bottom squad with the other 2. Because they aren't Yunari.
Alright, so 2 shots into the bottom squad of Rangers. Hitting on 5s. Nothing.
It's each time a unit is completely destroyed within 7 inches.
On the back squad.
So
of
even
Banshees.
If they're not Yunari, they're within the Banshees and it kills them.
Is it a unit with that special rule die or something?
No, it's any. So if I kill an enemy unit, I get to do it too.
Wait, well, I mean, I don't think.
Oh, they can't act.
Yeah.
The Rangers can't act. Oh, they're out of 7. That's what you're saying.
Yes.
1 wound on your Howling Banshee squad.
The back one.
Yeah.
6 up.
Nope.
Dead. So that's 3 dead out of that squad.
And that's no more shooting. So Gene Stealers are going to attempt to assault the squad of Howling Banshees. Okay.
So the front squad has still 6 left, right?
Yeah.
So I don't believe that the... Yeah, so I don't believe that the Exarch has a pistol because of the mirror swords. Let me double check. Yeah, I don't think so. So 5 pistol shots. Nothing. Bring it in. Let's hug it up.
Starting in. 5 inches.
Thank you, Ben. No other assaults.
And I think the Swarm Lord's out of. Need to get a 12 to be able to assault them.
Well, and then that goes to the. He can't stand on anything above the ground floor. So it can't even technically be an assault.
Can we have that discussion with your Mollifing?
Yeah. I don't remember where we ended up.
I think we said that they could because, like, wobbly model, like if they can balance at all.
What it way goes to he can't stand here. Like he can't stand on something above the ground floor.
Nah.
So I don't think that goes into the wobbly model. Because it's like a demon prince trying to assault onto ruins.
So 18 attacks into the Howling Banshees, hitting on 3s.
This isn't gonna be good.
And wounding on 3s. So 1 minus 4 AP, and then 11 minus 1s.
So 11 minus 1s, and how many minus fours?
One.
So one's dead. And 11 fireballs. They're all dead.
Soul bears than the other squad?
Yes, I will. So you get to overwatch me. Now, these guys won't get to fight, though, right? Because it's not the...
I think they're
charging in the fight phase, so I think they can.
Yeah. And it hasn't, like, bypassed this step or anything, I think.
Yeah, I think you're right. Okay, so here we go. 11 inches.
Wow. Do you want to loop around?
Oh, plus three.
Do you want to
will loop around. That's a good one.
Metal squad. Banshee flank.
So you get to do all your attacks.
Okay, so now the Avatar of Death will go.
Oh yeah, both units charged.
What is it? Six attacks. Two pluses. All hit. Strength 6. So 2 pluses again, correct, Joe?
Yeah.
Reroll fail. 6 wounds at negative 4.
They're dead.
Soul burst. No, you already did. Feels bad.
It's true.
But you can consolidate.
Okay. I wish that those banshees could kill themselves. Because then I could teleport over. Because it's not a soul burst, it's just a...
Yeah. I mean, it's when an enemy unit dies. So if you wipe out...
if I wipe out those gene stealers. Oh, yeah! Alright, so the Howling Banshees. They get 2 attacks each. And then the Exarch gets 3. Hitting on 3s. Mirror swords you can reroll. So yeah, that is just 2 hits.
Toughness 4.
So looking for 5s. Nothing. And now the Exarch. He gets to reroll his failed hits. 2 hits. Looking for 5s. Nothing. So that was awesome.
It's pretty sweet.
Yeah. So, leaderships, the Rangers, they lost 1 on the top.
That's not going to be a test.
They're only 7, yeah, and then 2 on the bottom. They're good, and then the front squad was wiped out, and they're the ones that were cursed, so I lost 3 Howling Banshees, and they are LD8. And they're good.
No leadership test for the Tyranids.
Okay, so all the Eldar units have moved around. Gonna try to take out those gene stealers. The Avatar moved up to try to deal with these. But first off, psychic powers. So I'm going to attempt to cast Doom onto the squad of gene stealers from the Farseer. It goes off with an 8.
If you're out of 24, no denial.
Correct. Am I out? You measured this. I only moved a little bit. I moved further back. Guide onto Elec. Or, actually, no. Smite. I also cast Smite. Better move. 12. I will re-roll one.
Wait, you can Ghost Helmet, right? You ignore the mortal wound on like a 3 plus or something.
Then I get the D6.
Yeah, boy. You're just gonna
wait. Give me the book real quick.
It's like when you suffer a mortal. Wait, I guess it takes like D3 mortal wounds. I guess I don't know exactly how it works.
4 plus invulnerable save, can reroll 1 dice, ghost helm, roll d6 whenever this model suffers a mortal wound, adding 3 to the roll if the mortal wound was inflicted as a result of the psyker suffering the perils of the war. On a 5 plus, that wound is ignored.
Right. So it's going to be d3 wounds, and then it's what, a 2 plus you ignore it?
It looks like on a 5 plus, right?
Well, yeah, but it's
I add
from
3.
Yeah.
So on the 2 plus. So d3? 3. 2 pluses. So he takes 1 more wound.
And how many gene stealers do you kill?
I will use a command point.
And reroll that.
Puts me down to 4 command points. Oh, and I got a 1. That's awesome.
Can you remove the one closest to the solitaire?
Equal damage after all that.
It happens. So he's got 4 wounds left. And now the Avatar is closest to these guys. So he shall cast Smite. Goes off with a 7.
Now I'll attempt to deny from the Magus.
Okay. One.
And the 2 wounds.
And then I will cast Gaze of Yanid. Another Magus. Does not go off. Okay. And that's it for the psychic power phase. So, shooting. Illic is going to fire onto the Magus from in here. 2 plus to hit. Hits. 2 plus to wound. 6. So that is 1 mortal wound plus 3. Let me see the stats on it real quick. Minus 3 for the 3, yeah, for the APM.
That does 3 damage.
Yeah.
He's dead.
Okay.
Good shot.
Yeah, he got him. He finally did something.
Yeah, he missed his last, or he did a wound.
Yeah, he didn't wound. Or no,
yeah, because he wounds on 2 plus, you're older one.
That's right. So, Death Jesters, gonna both fire on the Swarm Lord. Just for effect. First Death Jester. 1 hit. What's his toughness?
7.
Okay, looking for 5s. Nothing. Second Death Jester. 1 hit. 1 wound.
What's the minus?
Nothing.
So 3 up. Good.
Alright. 4 snipers on top. onto the hive guard. Three hits. They just wound on four pluses, right?
No, I think they just tank four now.
Yeah, you're right. So they're T5, so one wound. No AP.
So they haven't moved, so they count as being in cover. So three up. Good.
All right. And then the other two on the bottom. The other warriors have three wounds still, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're just fired at the hive. One hit. Nothing. I believe that is all my shooting. So now on to assaults. The Avatar will go in against the Warriors here.
Okay. We're watching Venom Cannon. D3, 2. No hits. And then 6 Death Spitter shots. 1 hit. Wounding on 5s. Nothing.
Okay. I make the charge with 2.
You rolled
too? I rolled snake eyes.
Oh my god.
But it's okay. Because I was close enough. So over here onto the Gene Stealers. We'll send the Solitaire in first. 7, he's in. Death Jester Blue. 5, he's in. Death Jester Pink. 7, he's in. Troop Master. 7? I don't know. Okay. They move for the measure. Sorry, Joe.
I mean, I'm pretty sure this on my hand is 6 inches.
Yeah, you're probably right. Alright. So now on to combat. I shall go with how good are warriors in close combat?
Not good unless they're geared for it.
Okay. I'll go with the Death Jester, or then the Solitaire. Wow. Okay, 8 attacks. He's gonna attack with his Caress. So he'll be strength 5. 2's the hit. 5 hits. And strength 5, so 3's the wound. Rerolls from the Troop Master. Misses. So, 5 at negative 2.
5 up in bones. I lose 1.
Oh my god.
And then would you like to interrupt?
I will interrupt.
Okay.
So down at 2 command points.
Which Gene Stealer do you want?
The one against the Solitaire. So, 3 will go into the Howling Banshees, 1 will go into Blue Death Jester, I guess.
Okay.
So, 3 into the Howling Banshees, hitting on 3s. Wounding on 3s. So, 1 at minus 1, 1 minus 4.
Okay, minus 1, 5 up, good, and the minus 4 one just dies.
And into the Death Jester, wounding on 3s, 3 wounds, minus 1.
4 up and vulnerable, takes 2 wounds, gets 3 left.
That's all of mine.
Okay, Troop Master. Using the Caress, 2's the hit. 3's the wound. Rolling 4 at negative 2.
5 up in bones. That's all of them.
Okay. Too bad the Solitaire couldn't form that act. because he wouldn't have gone back and killed the Howling Banshee.
Oh.
And he should have killed all three, but I got lucky.
Are you gonna Soul Burst?
I'll Soul Burst the Howling Banshees into the Swarm Lord. So, they're gonna need, looks like 10.
Well, you could also Soul Burst the Death Jester and shoot again.
Yeah, but...
because the Banshees aren't gonna kill them.
But it's fun. It's really fun. I'm gonna do it. So I need a 10. Come on! Two Howling Banshees.
Oh, the Banshees don't get to
attack. Don't get to attack, and they'll get to attack. Never mind, I don't want to do that. I'm sorry, Joe. Yeah, the Death Jester, Pink Death Jester, will just shoot. And can he see through the door on these guys? I believe he can. All right, three shots.
So what?
Nothing.
What would make it? What would make it that they wouldn't get to fight?
Well, they hadn't attacked yet.
The Banshees?
Oh, yeah, just the solitaire.
Well, yeah, because they didn't charge either this turn.
Oh, yeah. Okay, they would have been.
So they would have been able to. I already shot.
Yeah. Well, I think what it
Danny is... Danny tricked me, Joe, because I know they would have killed him.
Yeah, I think if they've already attacked... Like, if you've already gone through them in sequence of the fight subphase... After they've gone in the fight subphase, Greg charges. I don't think they get to go.
Yeah,
Greg charges before they went in the fight subphase. I think they get to go. Yeah. But I'm not 100%. It's complicated.
So I think I would have been able to do it. That's
yeah, but you wouldn't have wanted to.
No, it would have been really bad, but I did want to. Joe knows I wanted to.
I wanted you to.
has the Avatar Soul boosted yet?
No.
Oh.
So he can double. So here we go. Six attacks, two up. Five. Shrink six, your T5.
Four.
So you have threes. Five at -4.
No saves. So roll them one at a time. It's D6 damage.
Two?
No, you can just roll them. Oh, no, I guess you're rolling one at a time.
Roll away.
One. We got two left. How many does that one have left on it now?
One wound.
Okay, so four. Two and I'll command point. Two. Fitting. So I have what, two command points left or three?
Three.
Okay.
So that's all your guys. So the lone warrior gets to fight back.
I can't believe.
It was bad.
It was really bad.
So three attacks. Hitting on.
Threes. Maybe I'll kill the Avatar.
Three hits.
Uh-oh.
Wounding on fives. No.
Okay.
And he's a synapse creature, so he's good. Since the Tyranid assaults haven't been as good as they are psychic phase and shooting, going to count on those two to kill the Avatar. Move the squad of neophyte hybrids into the ruin to fire at him. The surviving warrior fell back from combat with him. The unit of acolyte hybrids moved up to assault into him. The swarmlord moved around the corner of that building. And the unit of warriors moved up. Five god have once again continued to maintain their position, as have the zoanthropes.
Got a 4+ invulnerable save and a 6+ feel no pain. You'll never kill it, Joe.
He's invincible.
Going to start off the psychic phase, casting Smite from the Zoanthropes onto the Avatar. I'll reroll the one from the Neurothrope. Still a one. So five.
I'll deny. I do with a seven.
Alright. Smite from the Neurothrope onto him. Smite. Fails to go off.
That's right.
Got two command points left.
Don't waste them, Joe. Don't waste them.
I will use one to reroll.
No! All right, how many?
Three.
Okay. He takes two.
Then the Neurothrope will use Psychic Scream. Warp charge value 5. Goes off with 5. So, D3 mortal wounds. 1.
Takes another. He's got 6 left.
And then see if he loses the psychic power. No.
Put it in your ult. Is it just 2d6?
Yeah. So that's the Zoanthropes will cast. Here they choose it. They will cast Catalyst onto the unit of Neophytes. So Warp Charge 6. Any perils? It kills off. So it's a D3 mortal wounds?
Yeah, is it right?
Yeah.
3. So that'll be 1 Zoanthrope killed.
Shriveled on it. And what's the damage to me?
And they get a 5 plus. Feel no pain.
Oh, okay.
So last psychic powers to cast from the Hive Tyrant. He will cast Smite on the unit of.
Is this a Hive Tyrant or a Swamp Lord?
Swamp Lord. Keep calling him a Hive
he
Tyrant.
He is a Hive Tyrant, is he not?
He's not the Hive Tyrant.
He's gonna cast Smite onto that 2-man unit of Rangers. For 5. Get a 7. 1.
Okay. Remove one for me, Daniel. Thank you, sir.
And then visible within 24 inches. He will cast the horror onto the solitaire. Which at 6. Goes off of 6.
Okay.
So minus 1 to his hit rolls.
Alright.
And that is all of the psychic phase. Going into the shooting, I'll start with the squad of neophytes into the Avatar. So there is one auto pistol on the sergeant, hitting on 4. Miss. Then there are 7 guys with shotguns. 10.
Shot in the Avatar of death to death.
So 14 shotgun shots, it's plus 1 strength, right? If they're within half range?
Yeah, so strength.
So hitting on 4s. And wounding on 5s. 3 wounds.
Any negative?
No.
3 up. Ugh. 2 feel no pains.
Even shotguns to the face.
I know, he's down to 4 wounds.
2 flamers.
fives. Not. Got one.
One save?
Yep.
Three up. Good.
Okay. The hive guard. The three warriors will fire into the Howling Banshees.
Okay.
All their weapons. So, six death spitter shots. Getting on fours. Moving on threes. Three wounds, minus 20.
The other dead. No, one's an Exarch. It has two wounds. So the one dies and the Exarch takes it in.
And then D6 shots from the Bob Strangler. Six. Hitting on fours. And wounding on threes. Two wounds. Minus one.
Five ups. So, Soul Burst. Pink Death Jester will fire over on these guys. Two hits. One wound at negative three.
One dead.
Revenge.
So.
Hold on a second, Joe. They just died. I'm gonna teleport the Avatar of Death. Let me make sure I can do it. Inevitable death. Each time a unit, friend, or foe is completely destroyed, you may immediately remove the Avatar of Death from the battlefield and set it up again as close to the position of the unit, more than 1 inch from all enemy models. Incarn may not charge the turn it is set up in this manner. So, I should have done it before I shot. Do you mind if I do it?
I do.
Well, I think along those lines, both of those things trigger off the same event. So I think you could shoot or move her in either order. Because both trigger off a unit.
I'm gonna move it. So you're close enough?
What's that?
And I think the Howling Banshee will prefer the foe with the
moon. Okay. There.
I knew where they were.
They were up there. I don't know. I think it's close enough.
Now that the Avatar's the closest thing, the Hive God will shoot him.
Alright.
Nice.
Hitting on threes. And wounding on threes. Three.
Four up and vulnerable. Takes two.
I think it does D3 damage.
Was Greg just bamboozled?
I think so. Trickster.
And you're the Holocaust.
Yeah, D3. So 2D3. 4.
4 saves. This could kill him. What's he got? 4 left?
Yep.
A command point 1. And he's dead. That's
Soul
it.
Soul Burst.
Yeah. That's it. That was a bad move on my part.
The Swarm Lord, who outmaneuvered Kalga, has outmaneuvered
right.
Paltriona. So, the Swarm Lord can't assault the Rangers at all.
Yeah, I forget where we...
I think we said that you could assault. Because otherwise, like any big guys, you can just hide up a level
yeah, well,
from and they can't do it.
The specific thing, one of the things I was doing was, when we talk about that, I was saying like a demon prince could fly, so he can end above the ground floor. So a demon prince could...
It's quite alright.
A demon prince, it would be legal to assault these dudes on the top level via wobbly model signal. But it goes to... I don't know, I think the rules in general aren't clear. I think it's imbalanced that this guy up here is safe from him.
And I think...
But, rule is written, I don't know. Like, via that dude, just want to kind of do in regards to rules.
He can make it up, couldn't he?
It's a monster. They can't go above
the ground. They can't go up.
But, for kind of the purposes of stuff, do we want to do... It's not in their rules, but it would be an inch from the model, effectively. In that he is one story tall, so he could assault him.
Yeah, that's fine.
He couldn't assault the second story guy.
Unless he
could fly.
I'm fine
with that.
Let us know what you guys think, because bikes and monsters and stuff and vehicles can't assault up. So potentially, we could be an entire army of rangers, one floor off the ground, and be invincible
against monsters.
Like, to monsters. Wait, I mean, the other thing that, like, in universe doesn't make sense, because you just smashed the building.
So, all my shooting's done. Pistols. So, Swarmlord will attempt to assault the Lone Ranger on the
bottom. All right, I'll overwatch him. Nope. Bring it in.
Okay.
He's in.
Yeah, finally gets to do something. Instead of just blowing people up with his mind. So he gets 6 attacks. Hitting on 2s. Wounding on 2s. 3 wounds. That's minus 3.
Minus 3, then we can't make it. He's dead.
I can't believe it.
Each one does 3 damage.
Alright.
And he will not consolidate.
Well, I think that is it for the Yanari. I don't think they can recover from that.
And how many of your units have I killed so far?
I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 left, so you've killed 7.
So you only have your characters left on
the field.
All the characters except the Avatar.
Yeah.
Here.
You
but it's only that.
Who is your warlord? The Avatar?
Oh, yeah, no, the Farseer.
Oh, yeah.
So,
what was your warlord trait?
When he dies and comes
back. That's the, isn't that the relic?
That's the Phoenix. Oh, no, the warlord trait. I didn't pick a warlord trait.
Oh, man. That's why you lost.
So, with First Blood, I'm currently on 8 points.
Yeah, I can't come back, and the Solitaire is weakened. I'm going to concede unless you really want to play it out. But I
mean, if you want to. Getting kind of late over here.
Alright, I'll concede.
The psychic might. I've never run like a proper
psychic
on me.
Yeah.
It's kind of fun.
Got me.
Need to get some malceptors.
Do you think your character spam continues to work?
I don't think it's that bad, especially in this list. I don't think it did me that bad. Positioning the Avatar where I did was bad. I didn't think about it that they. I thought the Hive Guard had already fired. But yeah, I mean, I don't think it performed horribly or anything. We both did fairly poorly with our roles at certain key times. I mean, if I'd have killed the warriors over here and been able to assault the Zoanthropes, it would have been a different game. And then if I would have done it in the correct order, I might have been able to have done some more damage.